In County Mayo, one of the most difficult archaeological digs ever undertaken in this country has revealed dramatic new information about the early history of Croagh Patrick. Now, for the past 8 weeks, teams of archaeologists have been climbing the 2,500-foot high Holy Mountain every day. They do that to study the remains of an early pagan settlement found buried on the summit. And Jim Fahey joined them on that summit to bring us this report.
Shrouded in the mists of time and history, Croagh Patrick was once described by a West of Ireland bishop as one of nature's great open-air cathedrals, an awe-inspiring place which has attracted pilgrims since the dawn of Christianity, and even long before. Tradition has it that Saint Patrick fasted and prayed here for 40 days and 40 nights about the year 441. But long before he arrived, this breathtaking mountain is thought to have been a well-established center of pagan worship and ritual. Throughout the many centuries of pilgrimage and Christian worship, little study of the mountain's earlier history and perhaps darker past was ever undertaken. But for the past 40 days and sometimes nights, a team of archaeologists, who are now believed to be the fittest in Ireland, have climbed this 2,500-foot high mountain every morning to probe the rock-strewn summit here for traces of the early Christian, the pre-Christian, and the pagan.
Well, it is extraordinary, Jim. We start at the bottom around 8 o'clock or so, and then we climb. We come up from the Lacandy side. We don't have to come up the Pilgrim's Route. But no matter what way you climb, it's still 2,510 feet, you know. So people say to us, oh, you go the easy way, but there's no easy way, it's still that height. While you're up here, you have to make the most of your time, because, you know, if you forget, you can't afford to forget anything, and you go back down and get it again. It's a long way down.
We have a team of 8 people who climb every day for 8 weeks, whether it's sun or raining, and they're very dedicated to the work. It takes them an hour and a half to climb. They spend 8 hours working here each day, and at the finish of the day, they come down home again. But there's no doubt it's a very difficult job that they have to do, and the conditions that they have to work in are very difficult.
Over the past 8 weeks, the team of archaeologists working here on the oftentimes mist-shrouded summit have uncovered dramatic new evidence of the pre-Christian and the pagan settlements which once stood on top of this enigmatic mountain. A fortified wall or rampart which surrounded the entire summit has been located, as have the ruins of an encircling ring of stone houses on the slopes of the mountain. This wall is believed to be part of a hill fort dating back almost 5,000 years, clearly establishing the ritual or strategic importance of the mountain thousands of years before St. Patrick arrived here.
Well, Croagh Patrick's one of the world's great holy mountains, but up until very recently we knew very little about the archaeological context of the pilgrimage. So it's the highest settlement yet dug in Britain and Ireland. It's indicating an ancient ritual centre on the mountain, way, way before Patrick's time, possibly as early as 3,000 years before his time. So it puts the whole date and the pilgrimage tradition here right to the beginnings of Irish history. So it's really a first order in terms of its importance.
There's very little evidence, or written evidence, of times before Patrick. The only evidence which we can ever find is archaeology. People always naturally assumed that Patrick had some good reason for coming here. We now know the good reason that he came here is that this was an important site.
Having found conclusive evidence of the 5,000-year-old Stone Age settlement, the team is now trying to establish what kind of pagan rituals took place here in the days of the ancient Druids, and why it was necessary to fortify this already extremely difficult-to-reach site with such a massive defensive system.
That's a very good question. Part of it would have been, of course, as a shelter behind which settlements could have taken place. But it also presupposes, if you build a rampart, that there was a perceived threat or an actual threat. Now, it's hard to imagine one up here, but in Cathair Conree and a few other sites, they were fortifying these places. It throws back the questions whether they were ceremonial or ritual sites, apart altogether from settlement sites. But the presence of a rampart would indicate it was more than just a ritual mountain, that you had a fortified settlement on the summit itself.
Our belief is that this is a summer worship site. There is no evidence to us that people lived here. But I think it's much the same practice as today. People come up on pilgrimage. There are people who serve cups of tea here during the pilgrimage Sunday. We would feel it was the same practice, that people might have stayed for a night or two, that maybe some of the druids might have spent a week or two here. I think any of the rituals here would have been maybe worship of the sun, worship of the sun and the moon. Most of the experts would feel that the ritual practices of the early pagans was very much worship of the sun rather than human sacrifice.
Further evidence of what may have been taking place on the mountaintop 3,000 years before St. Patrick's time has emerged this week with the discovery of a tiny collection of Stone Age tools found close to the summit.
One of the plates we got was from a little circular hut site just outside the rampart, and that was almost certainly for a hide scraper, scraping hide. So it was a type of tool that would indicate not sort of hunting on the summit or going up for a hunting party, but rather a settlement site where they're actually living and working on the top. They have yet to be analysed in great detail. We'll be forwarding them to Cork to do that.
As well as the pagan and the pre-Christian, the team here has also unearthed the ruins of a previously unknown early Christian oratory. Next year, they're hoping to carry out further exploratory work to try to establish just how many more layers of history and prehistory lie beneath the rocky summit of this most famous of holy mountains.
We were recently invited to Washington, to the Smithsonian Institute, to the National Geographic Society, to the University of Pennsylvania. One of the comments they threw is, you mustn't look on this as an Irish mountain. This is a mountain of global significance. It stands with Mount Olympus, Mount Sinai, Mount Ararat, Mount Fuji as one of the great ritual landscapes of the world. So as Irish people, we tend to take it for granted sometimes, but it stands proud on a world scale, this mountain, and the archaeology and the pilgrimage tradition to go with it.